This evening's session is going to bring to completion Derick's euphonium solo album. Derick has been in our band nearly 40 years now, and this is a slightly different venture in terms of solo CDs.
We were anxious not to just record everything that had been done before, so most of the music is either new or unrecorded, except for one track.
We want Derick to tell what has been a remarkable story in the context of Salvation Army music making. And so the CD will feature music that Derick played when he was just a young player, music that has been commissioned for him, music that has a very special place in his life and in his career as a Salvation Army musician.
Just half a foot of rain out there today.
But it feels pretty comfortable tonight.
Yeah. How do you feel it's gone so far?
Well, I'm pretty pleased with it. And we're at the last hurdle tonight with the last three numbers. So yeah. That's a nice kind of nice feeling to be at the last session.
Yeah. Now, this CD, you didn't want it to be just like any other solo CD, did you? No disrespect to any other solo CD.
No, I didn't. It would have been easy just to pick another 12 tracks and record them solos again, all that kind of thing. But I didn't want it to be that way. So I think we've got a good mix of new material and previously unrecorded material.
Including a solo that was your very first euphonium solo. Starry Crown?
Yeah, that was my first solo. I remember playing in the senior band at Hamilton Temple back in the 70s, which sounds funny even to say that phrase now. Yeah. But there we are, and I remember playing a Starry Crown. So it's kind of nostalgic and personal, but still a good thing to record that solo. I think in some ways, I think the euphonium selected me. I think in a junior band in Hamilton in Scotland, my very first instrument was a tenor horn. And I remember playing my first solos on euphonium in the junior band when I was 10 years old. So I guess the euphonium found me at a very early age. I liked the sound, the way it could express itself, its lyrical qualities. It was a bit heavy at the time for a young junior bandsman to carry around, but I think I appreciated early on the way it could communicate music in different ways and different styles.
This is a musical autobiography, really. So it's Derick that's selected the pieces. He's had one or two new solos written for him, solos that reference solos that he's enjoyed playing over the years. So it's the CD is very much his choice. Thank you. Derick and I have been friends for a long, long time now. I have huge admiration for his sheer talent, as well as his consistency and his commitment to God and the Salvation Army. It's always a privilege to work with him, but particularly so on a landmark CD such as this.
Always had a great interest in brass playing and a personal interest in being the best that I could be as a player. And I always looked towards the great bands of the day, and the ISB was one of those bands. So yeah, when that opportunity came along, it was one, a great surprise, and a fantastic thing for a 20-year-old player. Paul Sharman has written a new piece that will open up the CD that we're recording this evening, called Forte, which has little quotes of other solos that have been written for me in the past. The opening, for example, is straight from The Better World, and one of the main links is from Everybody Should Know, and along the way there's some other little quotes that I think people will recognise.
After the allegro, Derick, one, two, three, the fourth bar.
With the technology these days, you can do some amazing things with editing.
Flat D.
However, we try not to do that. We try to get as close to a live performance as we can, just cutting and pasting maybe little bits along the way, rather than big chunks of music that take away the liveness of the performance.
Now, Better World is section R to the end.
The Better World is a very special solo, personally, to me. Norman Bearcroft, who wrote The Better World, was a great influence on my younger musical life.
and he wanted a new solo and wanted me to play a solo at the 1978 International Congress. And so I went round to Norman's house and we looked at different tunes and keys and finally came up with what is now the iconic solo, The Better World.
I'm really pleased he's chosen to play The Better World. I was playing in the band at the time that it was written for Derick. I was there at the premiere, and I've seen him shape and reshape it again. Every time he plays it, he brings something quite different to it. And so I'm pleased that he decided to record once again The Better World. It's his solo. Thank you. Star Lake Variations. We will start at bar 189.
I first visited the Star Lake Music Camp, which is very famous in the Salvation Army, in 1972 as a very young brass player. Some 40 years later, I was there as guest soloist and guest conductor. And as part of the week, we were asked to provide a solo item for one of the evening concerts. And we decided to improvise a set of variations on the Star Lake pep song, which all the students sing every morning, every evening.
Good for me.
Excellent work. Good, done.
Life of a day.
Okay, here we go.
This will be interesting.
Here we go.
About it, won't it? Okay, so we start at. Why don't we start at C? And it's all about rhythm here. Okay, C.
Life of a Day goes back quite a while, but to my knowledge, has never been recorded. The date on the score is 1971, and it's by a very famous composer, Bruce Broughton, who is now famous for all kinds of orchestral and film music worldwide. I managed to get a set of parts from the Pasadena band, and we revived the solo, and here we have a first performance of this solo on CD.
Okay, so it's already actually, in terms of its rhythmic structure,
a lot better.
Yes.
There is obviously just a few things going here and there.
I would say, when we get these subito
drops to piano, occasionally the bottom drops out of the rhythmic material because we've got a drop to piano.
Okay.
And I think we just need to keep right on our toes all the while with it. It's
okay.
Good, much, much better, thank you.
Right, you heard that comment, let's go. Section C, once again, C.
I think we work with a very efficient process. Steve, our bandmaster, makes it efficient and puts it on the band to prepare well and to perform well. We tend to run a piece through and then patch anything that needs to be fixed or sorted with the band or indeed the soloist.
Yes!
Thank you.
Okay, there's a sort of a patch that I think we just need to cover, and it's this poco poco crescendo.
The back end of that bar sort of seems to get unstuck rhythmically, which
I'm just going to say, if we can just bring the horns up a little.
Yeah, I think that'll help.
And just hang on to that, ba da de da da, and then the next sequence, ba 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 da de da da. Just lift it a little bit, and that gives Derick something to latch on to. Right, six before F.
Excellent work. So, M to the end, mother to the end is the only thing remaining.
Okay, so can we start six bars from the end?
So right on that.
Okay.
Six bars from the end.
Oh. Maybe not, maybe not.
Okay, let's try again. So why don't we just play the penultimate bar then?
I would like that.
What, last two bars?
Last two bars.
Okay.
Good. Yeah, got it. Thank you, everybody. Another piece that intrigued me when you decided to put it on the CD was Ray Solo. Now, if I was Ray's first signing in the band, you were Ray's first big money signing in the band. And yeah, I'm sure he's up in heaven there just smiling at the guy that he signed.
He's forgotten about the money, but the signing is probably very accurate. Yeah, the solo, The Pathway, actually goes back before the staff band. Ray Bowes was leading a musician's councils in Glasgow, and I was probably 16, 17 at the time. And that was a featured piece for a demonstration that he was leading on that day. So to come full circle and record that is kind of special. Pathway, which was a solo written by Colonel Ray Bowes, who was my first bandmaster in the staff band, is a special solo to me personally. And I thought it would be great to record this solo. It's a fine piece of music in a rhapsody style. Well, I joined the band as a very young bandsman, and he was very good at making sure I was okay, that I was settled in where I was living and things I was doing in the band, where I was working. And he was very good to me personally. It's always been very special to be part of any recording with the ISB. It's always has been and still is an honour and a great privilege to be part of such a musical ministry that goes worldwide.
I hope they will hear in some shape or form the remarkable talent that he displays.
week in, week out, season in, season out. I hope they will learn a little bit more about his life over 40 years as a Salvation Army musician. I know that every time he plays with real musicianship and with real personality. And I'm sure in this CD that will be, once again, evident.
I'm grateful to all those who have encouraged me. We all need encouragement, whatever level we're at. And I've been very grateful to all those leaders of the band, conductors of the band, who've encouraged me to give of my best and to keep going and looking for the next new thing and to try and, you know, up that level all the time and be as good as I can be. I think the ISB's role is very important. People look up to the band for new music. They look up to the band for role models, for aspects of musicianship that are of the highest level. And they look to people in the band to exemplify what the ISB means in context of a Salvation Army and being a Salvation Army musician.
Derick's career with the staff band is unparalleled. There has never been anybody in our band who has occupied a principal position for 40 years and done so as remarkably as Derick has done. So in terms of the ethos of the band, the history of the band, it's absolutely right that we should be producing a CD such as this at this time. He is a remarkable talent.
Just in the nick of time, that concludes the Derick Kane solo.
Congratulations, Derick. Another great job. We got a lot of work done this evening. These folk are terrific. We covered 3-4 solos, 3 big edit pieces. It's been a good night's work here at the studio. Derick and I, we go back a long way, and it's a joy to work with him, so it's just been a good night.
Well, it's always good to complete a session, and more than that, to complete the actual project. So, yeah, it feels good, you know, as long as you think you've done your very best and you've got the best out yourself and from the band and from the engineers as well, who have a very important job to do, producing your CD.
When all said and done, we're a Salvation Army band, so we hope that in some way we're going to communicate the message of the gospel through our music. But we want to bring joy. We want to bring a bit of joy to people's lives.
When you look back on 4 decades, you can't quite believe it, really. I still take my playing very seriously. I still take my practice very seriously. I try and not miss a day's personal practice, because that's important to me for my personal musical pride, and it's important for the band too. So I'm ready to go again.